As a project manager, we need to learn, acquire, and develop some skills and techniques to ensure project's success. There are many techniques required in a project. There are most common or used techniques, and one of this is data gathering techniques. Data gathering techniques are used to collect data and information from a variety of sources. We have 9 data gathering techniques used in PMBOK Guide, 6th edition. Benchmarking. Brainstorming. Check sheets. Checklists. Focus groups. Interviews. Market research. Questionnaires and surveys. Statistical sampling. Let us try to understand each of the data gathering techniques in detail. Benchmarking. Benchmarking is a technique by which an organization compares its actual or planned practices to those of comparable organizations. Benchmarking can be used to identify best practices, generate ideas for improvement, and provide a basis for measuring performance. The projects used for benchmarking can be within the organization, external to the organization, can be that of a competitor, can be within the same industry or from other industries. Brainstorming. Brainstorming is a technique used to identify a list of ideas by holding a group discussion led by a facilitator. The group can include team members and subject matter experts. It is a quick way to generate a large quantity of ideas. It involves 2 stages: idea generation and analysis. During the idea generation phase, the focus is on quantity rather than quality. Every idea is recorded by the facilitator. No idea is stupid or useless. Brainstorming can be enhanced through nominal group technique with a voting process. Check sheets. Check sheets provide a structured way to collect data about a potential quality problem. Check sheets may be used to quantify defects by type or by location or by cause. Check sheets are considered to be one among the 7 basic tools of quality. Though PMBOK Guide uses this tool only in quality management knowledge area, this is a generic tool that can be adapted for a wide variety of purposes. Checklist. Checklists are often used as reminders. It can be a list of items, actions, to-dos, or points to be remembered. It helps to ensure consistency and completeness in carrying out a process. Checklists are frequently used in quality control inspections to remind the inspectors of the various requirements that has to be checked. Auditors use checklists to ensure they audit all the relevant clauses in a quality management system. Focus groups. Focus groups bring together pre-qualified stakeholders and subject matter experts to get an idea of how the market will respond to certain features of the product. In a brainstorming session, you are looking at generating ideas, while in focus groups, you are looking at gathering the expectations and attitudes about a proposed idea, product, service, or result. Interviews. Interviews are used to elicit information from stakeholders by talking directly to them. Interviewing experienced project participants or subject matter experts can help in identifying requirements, risks, project constraints, acceptance criteria, quality needs and expectations, etc. Interviews are very useful when you want to collect confidential information. The interviewer should facilitate an interview setting that encourages honest and unbiased feedback. An interview can either be structured, semi-structured, or unstructured. Structured interviews include a list of predetermined questions, with little or no variation during the interview. Unstructured interviews, on the other hand, does not follow a set of predetermined questions. Rather, the interview starts with an open question, and further questions are posed based on the response to the earlier questions. Semi-structured interviews contain some key questions while allowing the interviewer to seek more details if needed. Interviews are generally conducted one-on-one, but it may also involve multiple interviewers and/or multiple interviewees. Market search. Market research is a technique that is employed in planned procurement management process. Market research can be used to help determine the market conditions. It helps to identify the products, services, and results available in the marketplace. It includes examination of industry and specific seller capabilities. Information can be gathered through conferences, online reviews, etc. Market research can help you identify emerging technologies. It can help improve the information in the procurement management plan, procurement strategy, procurement statement of work, and the source selection criteria. Questionnaires and surveys. Questionnaires and surveys are a cost-effective way of obtaining data from stakeholders regarding their needs and expectations. These are designed to quickly collect information from a large set of respondents. Surveys are useful tools to gather information about stakeholder satisfaction. Statistical sampling. Statistical sampling is used when it is impractical or too expensive to inspect each item during quality control. Sampling can reduce the cost of quality control activities. It is defined as selecting part of a population for inspection. Sampling methods include attribute sampling, discrete the result either conforms or does not conform. For example, a pass/fail report of a student. You can only have either pass or fail as the result. Variable sampling, continuous the result is rated on a continuous scale that measures the degree of conformity. For example, the marks of a student. One student can have 70 marks, while another one can have 85 marks. Statistical sampling is a tool/technique used in control quality process. The mentioned 9 data gathering techniques find applications in 13 project management processes. The following matrix helps you to picture the processes and the relevant data gathering technique used in those processes. Great job! Keep moving forward. See you in our next videos.